Aerospace insulation is the best thing since sliced bread, and soon it might be made from sliced bread. A group of researchers at the Harbin Institute of Technology in China have published a paper in Applied Materials and Interfaces demonstrating a new way to make carbon foam. It involves subjecting freshly baked bread to pyrolysis, which is when you heat a substance up to intense levels in a chamber with no oxygen in it. So what exactly is carbon foam? In general, it's a lightweight material made up of almost pure carbon and is extremely porous. There are two broad categories, graphitic and non-graphitic. Each type has its own properties. Graphitic carbon foams are highly conductive, both for electricity and thermal energy, also known as heat. Non-graphitic carbon foams have greater mechanical strength than their graphitic counterparts, and they act as thermal insulators. Heat doesn't pass through them as easily. Both types are chemically inert. Dr. Yibin Li, head of the research lab, realized that bread has the right structure to produce non-graphitic carbon foam. Like the foam, bread has open pores, and so his team subjected freshly baked bread to pyrolysis. As a bread aficionado, this makes me sad. But it's all in the name of science. The team heated the bread to more than 500 degrees Celsius, that's 932 degrees Fahrenheit, without oxygen to allow the bread to catch fire, the material carbonized. The result was a lightweight, strong material with thermal insulation properties. The big breakthrough here is that bread isn't expensive to manufacture. Typically, scientists must first manufacture one type of foam and subject it to pyrolysis to make carbon foam. Some of these carbon foam precursors are expensive to produce, but bread doesn't cost a lot of, bread. And what can you do with this carbon foam stuff once you make it? Well, it's lightweight, relatively strong, fire resistant, and a thermal insulator. Sounds like it would be right at home in the aerospace industry, where you need superior thermal insulation that can withstand the stresses of a launch. And if you're going to send stuff up into space, you want it to be lightweight. So let us toast these scientists for their discovery. Their work might help us out of a jam. Even the upper crust should tip their hats to... My crew is starting to give me threatening looks, so I'll just wrap this up. To stay up to date on the coolest stories every week, I have two pieces of advice for you. First, don't loaf around. Subscribe to the How Stuff Works Now podcast. Second, make sure to visit now.howstuffworks.com every day. And I promise I'll cool it with the puns.